At this time, I'd like to turn the floor over to your presenter, Trevor Walker. Trevor, you now have the floor.
Great. Thanks a lot, Brett. I appreciate it. Hello, everyone. Good morning, afternoon, evening, depending on where you are. I appreciate the time and your attending today's webcast around identifying the right technology to drive HR transformation in large enterprises. Again, my name is Trevor Walker, and I am the product marketing for BCom. And I have spent the last 25 years of my life helping HR, finance, and operations use technology to drive greater efficiency and to help to transform their operations through technology. Over the next 45 minutes or so, we'll be looking at first, just as a level set, we'll look at some key transformational drivers around global compensation and benefits, looking at that both from a business and a technology perspective. I'll then go through some case studies, three in particular, clients of BCom that have taken global compensation and benefits by leveraging the BCom technology to address some key specific challenges that they have, looking at what kind of solution they put in place, and then ultimately looking at the overall benefits that they were able to achieve. And then at the end, we'll look at some of the key takeaways, consistencies across those, and I'll do a quick summary of the technology and solution benefits that we provide to organizations, such as the three that we'll be talking about here today. So in studies over the last several years by organizations like Ventana, like Willis Towers Watson, by Hayes Group, and many others, there are four key challenges in global compensation and benefits that drive a need for HR to look at digital transformation, specifically as it relates to compensation and rewards on a global basis. So first is looking at sort of the ability to acquire the top talent that they need and the skills that they need to help manage their overall business environment. So it's getting an understanding of the needs and requirements of the top talent. How do we maintain those, and how do we leverage compensation and rewards to help keep those people in place and to continue to acquire the right ones to grow going forward? Secondly is ensuring that the compensation that you provide for those skilled individuals is competitive and will also help to drive the kinds of benefits and desires of people in science, technology, engineering, and math, the millennials, and other technology skills that you need, making sure that you have the right compensation to acquire and keep that talent. Providing a clear foundation for driving career advancement and making sure they have transparency of their pay and the value that the organization is contributing to them, ultimately helping to drive their comfort level and their career and where they're going, and ultimately help maintain job security so you have greater retention. And then lastly, the ability to ensure that employees are ultimately engaged because they have clear and transparent view of their compensation. Again, understanding how that drives back to the value that they're contributing to the organization and can ultimately maintain a clear and consistent career path in the organization. According to Ventana Research in particular, these four benefits here are really the key things that companies are seeking in a recent study that they did around technology and how they're looking to leverage technology to improve their overall compensation management processes. So first and foremost, they're looking for making sure that their workforce and their compensation goals are clearly aligned back to the overall business strategy and can help ensure overall retention and performance growth of the individuals within the organization. Secondly is the ability to drive efficiency in the processes, you know, with multiple spreadsheets, side processes, HRIS systems that may not be managing compensation and rewards the way I want, or multiple systems trying to do that, there's a need for them to have a consistency in the way they manage their comp processes, ensuring it's aligned to the strategy. That's about 50% of the people in a recent survey. They wanted to make sure that they provide transparency and visibility to employee compensation. That's both to management and to HR leadership. So we assure that we have the right kinds of drivers and the right focus, make sure that that compensation is matched directly back to the strategy, and always making sure that it's clearly aligned to the overall performance and value that that's driving to the individual and ultimately to the overall organization. And then lastly, the ability to pay for clear performance and documented performance and making sure that's clear and transparent to the end payee. In looking across our customers, which are large global organizations, all of them are committed to leveraging compensation strategically. These 10 key things that we see here are the primary reasons that they look to implement a new compensation management technology. I'll just briefly go over some of these. You know, they're looking for ultimately control, and that control is important because it allows them to have local control for regulations, pay scales, and other things that are important, but still linking that back to an overall compensation strategy and how that's implemented across the organization with the ability and tools to be able to automate that, provide the appropriate transparency, and maintain ultimate control, traceability, and auditability of that information. Secondly, is making sure that this is directly in the hands of the compensation experts so they can adapt those plans, but also so that they have the ability and flexibility to ensure that they can make the adjustments they need to always ensure that the compensation is driving directly towards the company strategy. As we already talked about, it's important for them to be able to link ultimately pay for performance, but also customers are looking for a way to get out of the multiple spreadsheets, side processes, multiple system, and have one single place where they have a total compensation view across the organization and the ability to manage all those processes, make adjustments as needed from one place, but then also being able to have a rich set of analytics so that it's robust. It's integrated and doing everything from delivering total compensation statements to the individual payees, but more importantly, the ability to do the rich analysis on that compensation data to, one, make sure it's always benchmarked and competitive from an industry, market, and local perspective, but also so that they can begin to look at their compensation relative to peers and competitors, and also understanding how that looks relative to overall pay fairness and competitiveness. With compensation all in one place, they look for the ability to manage overall compliance and risk. So having a centralized place that you can put overall control, ability to flex where necessary, but also being able to have a structured set of processes and full traceability from beginning to end so that they can adhere to any local regulations from a global perspective or adhere to, as we'll see in a few minutes, like Murphy USA did, be able to comply with the local pay scales that they have across the various geographies in which they operate. Clearly, the ability to simulate budgets, plans, and forecasts, but more importantly than that, being able to test changes to compensation plans, being able to look at maybe one-time cash payments or specific rewards, and what kind of impact that would have from a budget perspective, but also how that might impact the overall goals from a performance, company performance level, all the way down to how that may match back to what the individual contributes to that overall performance. Clearly, the key goal is using technology to help them to drive retention so that they can make the adjustments that are needed from a compensation plan, making sure that's fair and benchmarked against the market, but also that it's transparent for executives and for HR to make sure that they're maintaining consistency of what they're trying to drive, the value that they're trying to deliver to their individual employees, but then full transparency of that payee to understand how that links back to the company strategy and their overall role. And then ultimately, it's about driving efficiency in HR so that they can put their time in more value-added areas, continue to manage or look to manage compensation strategically, but do that in a much more efficient way than they might be doing today. So we'll take a look. Each company, we'll take a look at Murphy USA, JM Family, and CNH Industrial. Each of these companies had their own driver for transformation of compensation through the application of technology. For example, Murphy USA, it was all about wage control and pay fairness. For JM Family, it was about investing in a compensation platform so that they could drive and support the overall growth, both on the HR side as well as on the sales performance management side. And then for CNHI, which is a large global manufacturer, for them, it was a lot about centralization of the overall processes and capabilities, but then making sure they had good governance and control over that process, full auditing and traceability of that for global compliance, both from an internal perspective as well as from an external perspective. So let's take a look at each one of these and get a sense for how they've leveraged technology for compensation and benefits to drive greater efficiency in their organization. So if you look at Murphy USA, Murphy USA used to be part of Murphy Oil. This was the retail arm of Murphy Oil. It was spun out a couple of years ago, and after that spin out, they had a couple of key issues that they were trying to address. First and foremost was wage control and pay fairness, as I mentioned just a few minutes ago. They had wage scales that were not aligned. Overall, they did not have consistency in those. And then when you think about how those were applied from a local market perspective, that had a direct impact on the things that they were trying to accomplish. So what they found was in their current systems and processes, they may be paying employees that had some shortcomings. All right. So for one thing, maybe they were not able to support using different market-based pay scales in different regions. This meant that they could be paying too much wages in some markets, or they could be running the risk of attrition by not paying enough in other under markets or through underpayment. So at the same time, their salary review process was not automated. The merit increases were not consistent, and they were certainly applied unevenly or not at all. So if you imagine those things in and of themselves, created a significant amount of issues around retention. For example, they were experiencing or have been experiencing a yearly turnover rate of about 100% in the cashiers at their stores and over 40% in their store management. So they had set a goal as an organization to reduce the overall to reduce that attrition rate by at least 50% as quickly as possible, because you can imagine the cost, time, and effort that was associated with trying to constantly recruit and trying to keep those people happy. So Murphy USA sought a technology platform that would enable them to manage these local pay scales, automate, and get consistency around the increase process and the merit process. And they wanted to do that by making sure that it was consistently benchmarked against the local markets, and that they could drive some cost efficiencies in their overall processes. So they're looking to be consistent in the way they implemented merit increases, have some standards relative to that, but also have consistency of when those things were applied. After they spun off from the parent, they were managing their entire year-end bonus processes on spreadsheets. So they were looking to get out of spreadsheets, automate that process as much as possible, and then provide greater reporting and analysis around that relative to the value that that was contributing to the organization and how consistent that was at matching the expectations they believed and they knew were important for those individual employees, so they could reduce that overall retention rate. And then lastly, they had the impending Equal Pay Act, and they were looking at the things that they would need to do in their existing systems, manual processes, side spreadsheets, getting out of that so that they could better manage their pay from an equality perspective with that upcoming and impending regulations, but then also how could they leverage that as a catalyst or an additional driver to gain benefits in all the other areas like retention and these wage scale issues. So if we look at the solution that was implemented by Murphy, they were able to implement wage control for over 13,000 hourly employees across their 1,200 locations. This meant that they were able to have consistent control over the merit and the salary review process across all those locations and geographies. They were able to integrate all of the local pay scales and yet still drive some consistencies across those, and making sure also that from a review and from a process perspective, that they were more consistently making sure that the people that were due for reviews, the people that were due pay increases relative to those were automatically managed as part of their process. So they got away from all of these inconsistencies about when they paid, when they managed promotions. So again, trying to make sure they attacked that overall retention issue that they had at their retail locations. They also implemented the automated bonus process for all levels of the organization. So they took everything that was in Excel, pull that in alongside their wage control and their salary and merit review process. This helped them to drive consistency in the way that process was managed, get greater insights into where bonuses were effective and not effective, making the appropriate changes, and also making sure that they were accurate in the way that they were calculating, delivering, and communicating these bonus adjustments to their individual payees. As I mentioned, also, they were able to streamline their overall salary management and merit process through the integration of performance ratings. Again, alerts and consistency of when those reviews and adjustments need to occur. They also were able to wrap those processes in workflow so that you had greater collaboration between management and the HR individuals that were involved in that process, but doing that in a way that's rule-based so that they had some consistencies in how much and when those adjustments can occur, and they had the appropriate bracketing so they could ultimately keep global control over how they paid and how consistent that was across market and consistent back to their overall guidelines that they had from a salary and merit perspective. They were also able to leverage the simulation component in BCOM that would allow them to simulate any plan change, understand the impacts of that change, either from an effectiveness perspective or all the way down to maybe budgetary impacts, look at all of those before they actually enacted those changes, and if necessary, collaborate so that there was appropriate reviews and approvals to make sure that those changes were both in line with what they wanted to accomplish, as well as had the appropriate buy-in from management and from leadership before they actually took those live from an organizational perspective. And then they were able to, through the single platform, now have a full view of all compensation. So rich reporting from not only from an HR perspective, but all the way down to the individual transparency that a payee would need for either commission statements or for a total compensation statement. So they had that visibility for both HR and all the way down to the payee. But as David Crump mentions a lot as he speaks about the implementations and what they're able to accomplish, that the executives at Murphy USA are very data-driven, statistical and analytic individuals, so they consistently need views on the impacts of the compensation and is that driving what they want? Is that maintaining itself within a budget perspective? Is it helping to increase or improve, I guess, reduce the overall retention problems that they had? And making sure that they could deliver that information not only tactically to HR so they could do what they needed to do to improve that over time, but also the executives could understand that that was consistently in alignment with their overall global strategy for compensation and rewards. So in looking at the benefits that Murphy USA was able to achieve, as I mentioned, the key for them was consistency and control. So they feel like they now have taken all of these different systems, side to manual processes and spreadsheets, integrating, automating, and optimizing those in one single place, and ultimately being able to manage those multiple pay scales. That was the impetus and drove the original selection process that they were looking for. And as estimated by Dave Crump, they expect that they can save approximately $2.5 million in the first year just by managing better the wage control issues, the multiple pay scales, but then consistency in the way they handle the merit and the salary increase process to reduce the overall retention issues that they had. They were able to, as I've said, streamline the management of those multiple pay scales across geographies without a whole lot of complexity or programming or technical things to try to make that happen. It was easy for the compensation experts to be able to do that themselves. They were able to automate all of their increases, adjustments, and approvals and to do that in a consistent way while still being able to handle any one-time cash payments or off-cycle payments that they felt were necessary to, again, help address some of the retention issues they had. And as you know, I speak to David on a regular basis, and they're well on their way towards achieving that overall goal of a 50% improvement of the retention issues that they had. And they're well positioned to be able to manage compensation that's directly in alignment with their internal compliance, as well as anything that may come down the line with the Equal Pay Act or others. They're already well controlled and prepared to be able to do that. And they're already looking at the next step of their implementation, which is really looking at how do I now take this HR-based approach to compensation and now apply this on the sales side for commissioning so that we can ultimately reduce the risk and save cost relative to an in-house legacy system they have, and while also providing them all the same things that we talked about around streamlining that process, being consistent about how that's paid, and providing transparency of how people are earning commissions relative to the plans and markets in which they operate. GM Family is a large organization in the southeast of the United States that is focused on providing both, you know, they'll do everything from managing some of the, you know, if you've got a car and you're buying an extended warranty, they offer all of those solutions and capabilities in addition to operating. They're the largest Toyota dealer in the U.S. So they provide both a sales approach to selling Toyotas and other vehicles, but then also supplying all of the services that other dealerships would need, everything from you know, systems to be able to manage how they sell and service those vehicles, all the way out to offering extended warranties if those dealers want to do that. So if you think about what they were trying to accomplish in the beginning for them, right out of the gate, it was all about total compensation, right? It was about being able to replace an in-house developed system that they had for all of their sales performance management and incentive programs, their internal salespeople, but also their dealers and partners that they had. And then they also, on the HR side, had some general functionality, but were not able to handle even some of the advanced complexity they had around their you know, salary and merit processes, very similar to what we saw with Murphy USA. So they were looking for a solution that they could maintain themselves without either support from IT or some outside resources to help them do that, and to also cut the cost around customization of some internal homegrown systems and the spend that's relative to those individual systems. So they were looking for a solution that could do both HR and compensation in one place. Where they had the greatest amount of pain was on the sales performance management side. They were clearly not happy with the solutions they had in place. It was a custom developed in-house system that they had a bunch of resources in HR and IT working together to try to maintain. So anytime they had a change, there was an immense amount of complexity and a lot of bodies and fingers to keyboard to try to address that, which ultimately results in, you know, time and effort to be able to make those changes and also cost associated with that. They also had some very specific complexity around their volume pay plans they had for both their field associates and dealers. So not only the internal people, but other organizations that were external that still had to be paid a commission or were could participate in additional rewards relative to how much they sold and additional products they pushed. And they were not able to provide any visibility to their dealer executives on both a pay and a commission perspective. They're also looking to reduce the overall complexity. You know, how do I take all of these multiple systems, spreadsheets, and processes and aggregate those together, look for some consistencies and ways that I can drive complexity out of the process? They have a significant amount of complexity in their rules. How do they have the flexibility to manage those and to manage those directly themselves without IT or technical support, and the ability to better adapt plans so that when something happens or a change occurs, how can they make adjustments to those plans? And those could be everything from, you know, special incentives that they want to put in place and how quickly they can do that. Or if you look at the recent hurricanes in the southeast of the U.S., if an entire dealership's offline, how do I make adjustments to the commission plans to help either gate the volumes or change those plans so that they don't de-incentivize those dealerships that are trying to come back online or make up for challenges that may be, you know, acts of God or things of that nature. So they needed the flexibility and the ability to adapt both their plans, the rules, and some of the drivers for those relative to anything that may happen from a business or from a external perspective. And they were looking, they had a lack of system stability and security with a lot of side processes and spreadsheets, homegrown access developed system. They certainly didn't have the ability to scale that application. They had concerns around the security of that and ultimately the stability. If one or two people were the only ones that could manage that system, you clearly have a lot of risk associated with that if somebody gets hit by a bus or something of that nature. So they really needed to get better control over their system environment to be able to manage compensation for both internal payees as well as associates and dealers. And ultimately, as we'll see with any one of the customer things that I present, you know, the ability to improve both internal and external compliance and ultimately transparency from HR through payees was a key driver for them. So what they implemented was they looked to automate their salary, merit and promotion process, bonus, and long-term incentives for where they started. And now they're looking to roll on the sales performance management piece of that. They have a volume pay plan and a lot of complexities around that for their associates. So they're in the midst of implementing that now. And that's giving them the opportunity to drive flexibility both on the sales performance management side as well as HR to be able to adapt and change plans as needed to make sure they can spin up initiatives where they're necessary, but ultimately get overall control and manageability over their all total compensation processes from one place. They look to manage that that complexity and the matrix of all of their internal people, but also the associates' roles, territories, and dealerships that they have. So they have a significant amount of organizations, populations, and complexity around that, depending on whether you're looking at the HR or sales incentives perspective. And they look to, they've got a set of plans and rules that are now flexible, that are directly in the hands of the compensation experts so that they can dial those in as needed. Again, simulate and make adjustments to those plans and understand the impacts of those before they go live, and ensuring that they're in total control of those from both a control operational efficiency perspective, but also being able to adapt to any kind of change, whether that's, as I mentioned earlier, an act of God, or whether that's a change that's necessary from an overall compensation perspective. So from a benefits, what they're seeing so far is they're looking at, they've got a lot of operational efficiencies, and they're seeing greater financial return in the plans. They have direct line of sight or visibility into how efficient those plans are, the kind of changes that they need to make, so they're constantly adapting and making changes to those. And they're a lot more agile in their ability to create specific incentives to drive campaigns or to drive attack key performance indicators they have around retention, performance, and things of that nature. Because they are now managing everything from one single system, all of those side processes and manual spreadsheets are gone. They're mitigating the risk and cost associated with that legacy in-house sales performance management system that they are in the process of sunsetting. And now they have a single total view of all compensation from one place. It enables them to, at any point in time, better manage or better forecast both the compensation and any accruals that they need. It's also because of the number of people they had managing processes in the past, both in HR and IT. It's allowed the HR team in particular to take those resources sort of and focus them and realign them on other areas of the business. And one area that they've started to invest more significantly in is the area of analytics, trying to understand, you know, pay fairness and competitiveness, understanding the efficiency and effectiveness of the plans, and being able to simulate and model what plans, what changes might impact those, as well as ultimately the overall cost associated with those plans, and the way that aligns back to any budgets and forecasts that they might have. They also have achieved much greater clarity and transparency around the way they're paying individuals, how that aligns directly to their performance management initiatives, but also looking at how that aligns directly back to strategic initiatives that the organization has, and how compensation can directly affect that from an organization. And they, you know, they'll clearly communicate that, you know, for them now they've got a compensation platform that will allow HR to do the things they need to keep that compensation strategy aligned with the overall corporate strategy, but also is something they can manage themselves to facilitate any future growth or changes that they need to make. The last case study we'll take a look at is CNH Industrial, a large manufacturing organization on a global basis. You know, this is an organization that it's Case New Holland, so they make everything from tractors and farm equipment all the way through to heavy equipment for mining and things of that nature. If you look at what their overall business need was as an organization, you know, they had first and foremost the inability to forecast compensation. So they had no control over what they were paying, how they could manage that or anticipate that to facilitate the rapid growth that they were experiencing as an organization. They also had a significant amount of problems or challenges around the ability to accurately calculate compensation, deliver that on a timely basis, which ultimately leads to trust issues, right? You know, there was always sort of jokes internally in the organization when you ultimately were paid, you had no transparency on how they ultimately arrived at that, why it took them so long to calculate what should be a standard annual bonus process or salary review process. And ultimately, it created trust issues, both on the HR side for normal employees, but also on a sales compensation perspective. Lack of clarity on how I'm commissioned, questions around transparency and trust relative to those ultimately creates issues on motivation and success from a sales person and a sales efficiency perspective. They also had a number of, as we've seen with most of them, and I'm sure most of you on the phone still have a lot of manual side processes, so they had a lot of inefficiencies around those processes, how they could get control over them, and how they could centrally manage them to accomplish their overall goals. And there was no transparent link between, you know, the performance reviews and the performance of a payee, and ultimately how that was transparent back to how that resulted in their overall total compensation in terms of value contribution of the organization to those individual employees. So ultimately, they needed a system that would allow them to centralize all compensation, get greater control over that process, both from international regulations they need to adhere to, as well as local regulations, but also with a centralization of that, can they drive greater efficiency and optimization? So they speed up the process, deliver greater accuracy and transparency in that pay, and then ultimately make sure that they can improve the overall trust in the compensation plans and programs that they had in place. So CNHI has been a customer of BCOM for a number of years. They started first with the salary and bonus process. That's been the primary one for over 35,000 plus employees on a global basis. And now they've just this year have been implementing the sales performance management for all of their sales payees. So ultimately, if you look at this, this is a global implementation of BCOM to manage total compensation, whether it's HR all the way through to the sales compensation for all of their 35,000 plus employees. They have compensation plans in place with a clear set of metrics that are aligned directly back to the business goals, but also directly aligned back to the individual performance ratings. So there's a direct line of sight for both HR and for the payees to understand how their compensation contributes directly back to those overall goals and to the performance as an individual, how I'm compensated for the amount of work and contribution that I deliver to the organization. They also leverage significantly our simulation component so that they can optimize their plans, test any of the changes, make sure that it's going to accomplish what they're looking for, to ensure it's within the budgets and forecasts that have been set in place, and to be able to do that with the appropriate approvals and workflows so that that's sort of blessed before those are rolled out into production across the organization. On the sales side, they have very complex payout curves, and these payout curves, there are multiple ones by geography and by level, and each one of these have different gates relative to when certain things will trigger certain payments or accelerators. So they have a lot of, it's very similar to Murphy, where they had multiple pay scales, they have multiple pay scales per geography. There's a very similar thing here on the sales side where there can be multiple payout curves, and depending on which geography, sales team, or metric is in place and the ultimate achievement against that will trigger different commissions, different payments, and different accelerators or incentives that could get triggered based upon that. So there's quite a bit of complexity around the plans themselves, how those are measured, which curve gets applied, and then any additional incentives or adjustments that will get triggered automatically based upon performance and achievement. They also have do significant territory and quota management so that they can keep manage regular updates. I think they do quarterly updates on their quotas. Territories are set at the beginning of the year, but those are a critical element back to how they're going to get commissioned on what they sell. And they also have a lot of complexity around keeping track of the sales reps, their mobility, and how that directly links back to what compensation plan, the multiple and complex payout curves, and what territories and quotas that they ultimately have to retire and manage over time. They're now finally achieving accuracy around the payouts through both the way they manage that and have automated that process, but also the approvals and workflows that are associated with that and the full auditability from the beginning all the way through to the end, whether that's auditability and traceability from an HR perspective or all the way out to commission statements and total compensation statements that are now delivered on a much more timely basis directly to the individual reps or payees. And through the information that they deliver, giving them transparency and visibility so it's clear to the payee that I'm now getting paid on time, I have greater trust in the accuracy of these payments, and I know how it directly links back to the way I'm performing and the things that I'm incented on as a payee. So over the last 2 years, in particular, CNHI has been able to more consistently manage both an increase in their revenue and their forecast accuracy. As I said, they've centralized all compensation in BCOM for one singular platform to meet all of their internal and external alignment and transparency goals that they had set out as an organization, and most importantly, to address some of that timeliness and accuracy issues they had, and ultimately trust when you consider making payments and compensation adjustments to individual payees. So for them, it's all about making sure that those payees are happy, motivated, and understand that the value that they're contributing as an individual back to the organization. So they spend a lot more time now providing value to the business and less time trying to manage the overall compensation. And with that process control that they've put in place, again, they can ensure fairness of that compensation and have an overall view of how they're performing, whether those plans are meeting the efficiency and effectiveness that they're looking for, and it's directly in the hands, as I've mentioned, with the others and the compensation experts to be able to make those changes without resorting to Excel, side processes, or some sort of IT support to be able to do that. So if you look at what do all of these case studies have in common? We're seeing with leading organizations like these, the companies are looking to take advantage of technology so that they can fully capitalize on the power of compensation to drive performance, to drive retention, and provide greater transparency and auditability in these processes on a global basis. So for them, the thing you'll see that's consistent across these organizations is to them, compensation is just not about paying someone. It's about making sure that compensation is a mission-critical component that they have as an organization. They don't want to make any compromises on the plans or drivers that they think are important to leveraging compensation for them to drive and meet the business goals they've set out with the organization. The second thing is that all of these organizations considered that compensation was core, and having a central compensation system that would allow them to manage that all from one place was core to the overall transformation, not only for them as an HR organization, but also with insight and visibility, they could begin to transform their individual compensation plans to match more consistently back to the overall company strategy and drive transparency and retention across their entire organization. And lastly, for them, it was really about making sure that the HR compensation experts, the people that really know compensation and need to manage that, could do that directly themselves without constantly resorting to manual processes or side spreadsheets, because either an HRS system or some homegrown system they had in place required IT or some technical resource to make a change. They were expecting the ability for them to have that capability to directly in their hands, so that they were, I guess, in control of their own destiny and how they manage compensation to drive the organization strategically. So they all look to select a best-in-class compensation solution that, again, would let them drive and link their business strategy and individual performance back to ultimately what the compensation drivers were doing for both salary, merit, bonus, long-term incentive, or as we've seen in a couple of instances, also the sales incentives. So they were, all of them were looking for a total compensation solution that would let them manage, in most cases, HR and sales together, as we've seen with CNHI and with all three of them, they had the same incentives. They were looking for a solution that was, there were no functional limits, so they could manage compensation exactly the way they wanted. They didn't want to have to compromise because, again, as I mentioned, for them it was strategic as an organization to leverage compensation, so they don't want to have to compromise on that at all. It was important for them to make sure that all the business users and most importantly the compensation experts directly had the ability themselves to analyze the plans, make changes to the plans to ensure it was always in alignment with what they were trying to accomplish, and to do that on a solid foundation of both security and compliance. The other thing we consistently hear from our customers is that they also wanted to work with a vendor that, you know, they felt like was a trusted business partner, somebody that had deep domain expertise in global compensations and the challenges associated with that, that knew how to implement technology to try to address those things for large, complex enterprises like we've seen here, but also had credibility and were trusted as an advisor to both help them in any changes that need to be made to compensation, making sure that the system was implemented with the utmost in flexibility and capability so they could make the changes that they needed ultimately over a longer period of time. So BCOM provides a total compensation cloud solution that is focused on allowing organizations like we've seen here, large global organizations, manage both their HR compensation, whether that's salary or merit reviews, all the way through deferred bonus, long-term incentives and accruals, as well as in the same place being able to manage all of your sales compensation. So you have a clear, consistent view globally for anybody that's getting paid, whether that's a commission all the way through to long-term incentives, being able to manage those from one place. And on the sales side, being able to manage not only the incentives, but being able to take care of all of the quota and objective management, territory management, as we've seen with JM Family, the partner and channel manager, or in their case, dealer management, that they needed to be able to manage. So for us, it's all about putting that in one single platform so that you have the ability to simulate, model, plan, budget, and forecast those things, get control over the processes themselves to drive efficiency, but also make sure that there's visibility in workflow and approvals, but also making sure that matches back to either the global consistency you're trying to drive or the local pay scales that may have a direct impact or the regulatory environment in which you operate on a global basis. And doing that with a clearer set of communication vehicles from HR and executives all the way down through individual payee, but also with rich reporting and analysis for everything from total compensation statements to being able to look at how I can benchmark my competition against the overall market, or being able to look at how I'm doing from a gender and pay fairness perspective, and doing that in a solid foundation of compliance. So any regulatory reporting that may be done locally, globally, or to the board, being able to do that from one single and consistent place. And because BCOM focuses exclusively on managing compensation and performance for large enterprises, here we see we have over 100 plus industry leaders on a global basis that use BCOM to manage compensation, and to do that in a way that matches exactly the way they want to manage compensation, automate and reduce a lot of the manual effort and improve the workflows and approvals associated with that, and providing clear transparency, whether that's audit and compliance reporting or all the way down to providing transparency to the commissions and total compensation statements of your payees. And we're managing annually over $300 billion in compensation for over 1.6 million users, driving, as we've seen, strategic impact to those organizations, much like what I've mentioned in CNHI, JM Family, and others, being able to help them reduce the overall cost associated with managing compensation, side processes, headcount to manage those things, improving the overall accuracy and timeliness of compensation because it's now centrally managed, automated, optimized as much as possible, improving productivity of your individual HR BPs, as well as all the way out to individual payees through transparency of what they see for their contribution as an organization, and then ultimately being able to leverage compensation to drive back to the overall strategy of the organization, ensuring that that is consistently and constantly aligned. So with that, I want to thank everyone for their attendance today. I think everyone's been submitting some questions through the interface. So I'll look at a couple of questions we have here. One of them is, does the solution also account for executive plans, including phantom stocks, options, and investment funds? Yes, when you look at on the HR side, the way you're managing both your long-term incentives, your executive comp, and some of that may involve some deferments, all of those are managed in BCOM, and the ability to set up all of your vesting schedules, the payments associated with those, and manage those directly from within the solution is a core part of what we provide. And we see, you know, we have some of our customers that start with LTI or deferred compensation as their starting point, and they may ultimately roll into other places as well. So yes, the solution supports all of the complexity around executive compensation, stock option plans, and all the vesting schedules or maturization schedules that may be associated with those. Let me look at a couple other questions here. Are there any other questions? Okay. Well, with that, I guess I'll give everybody 10 minutes back. I hope you found this presentation useful. I wanted to try to attack it as much as possible from a, you know, real life scenario across the multiple industries that our customers are achieving or trying to accomplish with BCOM. So I really appreciate everybody's time. And if there are any follow-up questions, feel free to reach out to myself, and I'll try to get back to you as soon as possible. So thanks again for your time today, and look forward to talking to anyone or addressing any of your follow-on questions. Have a great day, everyone.
Thank you, Trevor. There are a few things I want to go over before we finish, everyone. As I mentioned during my introduction, I would like to push out the survey to everyone. We do appreciate your feedback and ask that if you take a few moments to respond to the short survey at your earliest convenience, it should open in a new web browser. This webinar will be available for playback for up to 90 days. Simply log into worldofwork.org and in the My Profile section, click on the My Online Education link. If you want to obtain HRCI certification credits, the HRCI program ID number can also be found on your My Profile page under My Professional Development Credits. Please allot 24 hours for that information to appear. Thank you, everyone. That will conclude today's webinar.